morning. Please sit down. My name is Kiranjita. What's your name?
My name is Asthagana.
And what's your name? You are Asa Agarwal 2A and you are Samishna Kirana 2B. Okay, Asa, tell me something that you like about your school.
My school's library is really good and our art room is wonderful. I like one thing of my school that individual attention is given to every child and equal opportunities for girls are also there.
Okay, Samishna, tell me. Do you like watching TV?
Yes, ma'am.
Why?
Ma'am, after whole day stress, I refresh, relax myself by watching TV. It is a very entertaining media and it gives us knowledge also in discovering channels and many other channels.
Okay, Asha. Now you are going to tell us about your topic. And when you are finished speaking, then Samishtha will ask you a question and I'll ask you some more questions. So would you like to begin, please?
Then my topic is adventure. Adventure is an exciting or unusual experience. It is generally cold, usually risky, undertaking with an uncertain outcome. Adventures are usually involving the things which are actually risk-taking, such as mountain climbing, river rafting, or maybe just climbing the mountain or crossing a river. Adventures add spice to life. One should be really very much strong to do any adventure, mentally and physically prepared. The qualities required for adventure are extraordinary courage, curiosity, risk-taking ability, and at the most spontaneity. Besides these qualities required, one must also have the necessary equipment and accessories like food, shelter, clothes, etc. First aid should also be taken. In fact, I will say for any type of adventure, you must at most carry first aid. During adventure, one has agonizing movements. One feels euphoric. Adventures, although I have not done any type of adventure, but still if I will get a chance with proper guidance, then I will like to do my question.
Okay, okay, Samishtha, can you ask the question, please?
Okay, Asha, you have just said in your topic, in qualities of adventure, you have used the word spontaneity. What do you think of this? Spontaneity means that first of all, if supposing I have just caught up in any of the problem, then I should see the possible options which are besides me. So I have to choose the best option, analyze that, and then promptly act on it.
Yasma, which adventure activity you like the most, that you really want to do? Why?
Ma'am, because it is really very exciting. When I have gone once on mountain climbing once, then I saw that the girls were also doing, so I thought that I should also do. So when I climbed up, then I was really very cool.
Thank you. Now, Samishtha, you will be speaking on your topic, and after you have spoken, then asking will ask you a question and I'll ask you some more questions. So would you like to begin?
My topic is travel and tourism. Travel means moving from one place to another. And the tourism is the travel which is done for recreation, leisure, and for many other purposes. Tourism has become a very famous leisure activity in today's world. Many countries have increased their economic growth just because of tourism portfolios of their countries. Our country, India, has also increased 20% of its so that can I can increase my knowledge.
Okay, Samishtha, you must have traveled various places, different places. So, which place have you liked the most and why?
Mom, I like the hill areas because when I've gone in Jammu and Kashmir, I've felt very good. It was a very great experience in my of my life. I like hill areas very much.
Okay, thank you, Samishtha. Now we have next task, and the task is I'll give you a card. It's a problem card, and you have to come up with a solution after reading this problem. I'll read out the problem for you. Your friend spends all his free time watching television. With your partner, discuss what problems can this lead to. How can he be encouraged to take up more productive activities? So you have 2 minutes to discuss this and come to the solution.
I think that watching TV is good, but more watching TV is not good for our eyes also. Our eyes will also be affected, and our friend should go out and play instead of watching TV. Yes, excess of watching TV will affect his eyes and his general health also. He will not be able to, he will not take interest in his studies because of excess watching of TV. He will kill his imagination, and he should be encouraged to play outside of the games, which he should do creative works like painting and drawing instead of all time watching TV.
Can you agree on a solution?
Yes, ma'am. He or she can do lot many things instead of watching TV. He or she can play sports, many sports like basketball, badminton. And I think that excess of watching television will kill his imagination, and it will affect his general health. Body language will also be depleted. He will just think what would happen in that movie, in that thing, what was happening, and I should also be like that. So it will, after all, kill his imagination, and he will not be able to write a new story.
So do you think he would listen to your advice, and it would serve the purpose?
Yes, ma'am. We will make him understand. There is very much of violence in serious, and he or she will also become violent, so he should not touch. And we will give